Romo, you crazy.
He and his feelings, he called me to tell me it's over again. He sending money again. Nigga, a dummy again. He think I'll play him again. But did he want some to do it again? He coming right
over. Back to my YouTube channel. I'm back at it again with another girl's talk part two video. So we're gonna get into this video. We're gonna get it juicy. I'm gonna lay down everything for my young girls and some stuff that older women have taught me. And you know, I'm just gonna lace y'all up on everything that I know and I feel like I want other girls to know, because we need to have this talk, ladies, because we gotta be put on game. And there's a lot of stuff I wanna put y'all on game about, because people put me on game, so why not put y'all on game? But first and foremost, let's get into this top. This top is from Sassy Collections. Y'all please go shop with Shania. Everything is good. I am a brand ambassador, so you guys will get some pictures from me on Instagram. I'll put my Instagram below. So you guys need to, you know, go like and comment under my pictures and also follow me. And then make sure you go grab this top from Sassy Collections. The link is in my bio. Mwah. Thank you. And I also have a promo code that you guys can get a discount on. So yeah, we locked in. Like, let's get this work done. All right. So first, I'm doing this girl talk part two because I feel like in part one, I really didn't get to say everything I wanted to say, and I really didn't get to put people onto a lot of game. So, first and foremost, this is what we're gonna talk about. Welcome to my table talk. We are going to talk about men. Actually, you know what? Not men. We're gonna talk about boys, because I feel like, you know, everybody is in that age where, like, from like 13 to like 18 to where you meet a lot of boys, not men. So boys, okay, so you know, dating is cool or whatever, you know, like, you know, you never know when that person is gonna come into your life. But my point is on guys is red flags, stay away from the red flags. If this guy shows you a red flag, then you need to leave, because you know, like, it's easy for a girl, well, me as an example, to think, oh, okay, you know, no, he's not like that. Like, it was just an accident. We're human. We make mistakes. If a guy does it once, he's going to do it again. Like, he does not care. Like, and I feel like once you see that red flag, you need to leave. Because if you don't leave, then you already been messed up. Like, you're already stuck. And you don't want to be stuck. Like, nobody don't want to be stuck. You don't want to make a mistake and then be stuck for life. Like, that is so sad. Who wants to be stuck for life with somebody that's not right? Not me. And that's just not right. So another thing with the guy, don't let a guy peer pressure you into having sex with him. Like, just tell him no, you're not ready, you're not comfortable, and let it be that. And like, if a guy is trying to do something with you as soon as y'all meet, like, say for instance, if he's like, let's chill, and he's like trying to do stuff with you, that's a no-go. No, don't talk to him anymore. Move on. Because a guy already knows what he wants to do with you as soon as he sees you and meets you. So if he pulled that on you, then that's all he's gonna ever think of you. So it's just kind of like, at this point, it's no straightening that out. Like, if a guy genuinely has respect for you, he wants to be with you, he's gonna, you know, he's gonna be like happy every time he come around you. He's gonna want to take you out. He's gonna want to make you smile. Forget sex. Like, all of this is on your time, and he's not thinking about that. He's gonna do everything he can until whenever you guys are ready, he's gonna be ready when you're ready. No ifs, ands, buts about it. That's what a real man is gonna do. He's gonna be a man. He's gonna buy you flowers. He's gonna open your door. Like, men are supposed to open the door. Like, you're supposed to open the door for me. Like, what are you talking about? And it's like, you don't want no little boy. Like, you don't want nobody that's out here playing around every day, you know, talking to other girls, getting you caught up in this, got people laughing at you. That's embarrassing. And trust me, I've been embarrassed. Nobody want to feel embarrassed. Everybody want to feel wanted. Everybody want to feel special. So I feel like don't let a guy peer pressure you into thinking that he's the one for you. And don't let your hormones and emotions take over, because that can be really, really bad. So I just feel like wait until you find the right one. He's going to come. Don't rush it like me, because I'm always rushing stuff. Just be patient. Just focus on you for right now. Another thing with guys, let's see. Guys can be very manipulative. Like, don't let a guy tell you what you can and can't do. Don't let a guy run all over you. Don't let him be like, oh, you can't wear this. Oh, you can't do that. Oh, this and this. Like, it's all of that stuff is cute to a certain extent. Like, I've never been in an abusive relationship, so I don't know what it's like to be in one, but I've saw them. So it's like, it's cute to a certain extent. Like, you want your boyfriend to be like, where you going? Like, what you mean where I'm going? Like, I'm finna go with my friends. Like, that's cute. Because it's like, at this point, he see I'm cute, da-da-da-da, boom. But then, when it's like, I had a friend that, like, her boyfriend didn't let her go nowhere. Like, we were supposed to go somewhere. He did not let her go. Because of what she had on, I was like, are you serious? Like, you can't leave. She was like, no. And I was like, it's not adding up. Because at this point, just walk out the door. So, don't let a guy dictate you like that. Don't let him put his hands on you. Any man that can disrespect you, call you out of your name, put his hands on you, does not love you. Let that nigga go. It's time to move on. It's 2020. We letting these niggas go. We are moving on. We're getting ourselves together. We might cry a little bit. That's okay. It's okay, but I'm going to get into that. But let him go. It's plenty of other niggas out here. And I mean, I'm not saying let him go and find somebody else. But I'm saying, like, let him go. Chill. Do you. Because I mean, like, just like how he came, somebody else going to come. So it is what it is. And you got to take life like that. Like, you got to roll with
it. It is what it is.
It is what it is.
And you got to take life like that. Like, you got to roll with the punches and you got to let stuff go. Next. So next we're going to talk about controlling your emotions. We're women. We're girls. Some girls that I know, like some of my friends, like they don't have emotions. Like, I have a nonchalant friend. Like, she don't have emotions. She don't know how to give a fuck. Like, when it comes to expressing her emotions, it's hard. And it's like, for some of us women, like me, I'm gonna tell you how I feel. I'm gonna let you know you hurt my feelings. I'm gonna let you know I'm mad. I'm gonna let you know I'm happy. I'm gonna let you know everything, because I feel like with me, that's a genuine part of me. Like, I can't act like I don't give a fuck, because I do. But once I stop giving a fuck, I don't care anymore. Like, that's just that. And as a woman, you have to know how to control your emotions, because I feel like we're all already targeted because we're women. So like, if a man see we weak, like, he gonna be like, oh shoot, I'm finna run over her. But in my head, like, as a young lady, I'm thinking, you know, like, that makes him see that I have a genuine heart. But not nowadays, ladies. I'm finna put y'all on game. Don't show a nigga how you feel. Don't let him know how you feel. You like that nigga? Keep that shit right here or right here. You like something about somebody? Don't tell him. Don't tell nobody. Because it's like, every time something happens, somebody gonna use that against you. And it's like, I have a hard time. I like to vent. And I'll get on Twitter and I'll be like, da, 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 I just feel like this. Or I get on Snapchat, I'll be like, I just feel like this. And I'm trying to wing myself out of that, because that's not good. Like, it's kind of embarrassing, because people be like, well, you was feeling like this today and you was feeling like that. And then they think they know you. And that's not true. But it's like, you don't have nobody to vent to, so you feel like that. But you can always vent to me. I put my Instagram and my social medias below if you guys need to vent. I'm very understanding, very, you know, heart to heart. So that's just that. But learn how to control your emotions, because, you know, people are like out. I'm not saying people are out to get you, but people don't always have good intentions with you in your heart. You got me. Good. So about self-esteem. I am really, really big on self-esteem, confidence, boosting other women up, feeling good about yourself. And I'm going to tell you guys why. I used to be very insecure, like a little bit, still am a little bit. I'm not really insecure because I know I clean up nice. Like, I know when I get my hair done, I put my makeup on, I put my clothes on, I clean up nice. Like, I'm good looking. Like, can't nobody tell me different, you know? Nah. But I used to get called the duff out of everybody, out of all my friends or whatever. And I was like, dang, because like I'm 5'9", you know, I got arms, I got thighs, I got breasts, I got booty. And I always wanted to be skinny, like my shoulders, I got big shoulders, I always wanted small shoulders, like I always wanted to be skinny. And I used to be real like depressed about that. And like in high school, I was a cheerleader, but nobody wanted to talk to me for some reason. I was like, what the fuck, brotherhood niggas at? Nah, I just went. I don't like you niggas, y'all. But no, I was like, bro, where's my soulmate? Like, I didn't have a prom date or nothing. But let's get to the point. Like, I was very insecure and about little stuff like that. Sometimes I still get insecure, like, when I think of stuff or, like, when I'm around. Like, when I'm around other girls, I be like, oh my gosh, she's so pretty. Like, I wish I looked like her. But it's never, oh my gosh, like, what the fuck? This is not fair. Like, nah, it just took me some time to realize that people are different. People have their flaws. People have things that like are really, really perfect about them and that are really, really ugly about them. And I feel like, you know, you can't go on life like being insecure, looking at other people thinking, oh, I wish I looked like her. Because people tell me, oh, I wish I looked like you all the time. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I wish I looked like somebody else. And I'm just like, you gotta learn how to love yourself. You gotta learn how to look in the mirror and be like, this is who I am. I gotta wake up. I gotta look at this face for the rest of my life. So it's like, I might as well. And, you know, just be confident. Like, don't let nobody tell you, oh, she look better than you. Oh, you ugly. Oh, you this. Oh, you that. Because at the end of the day, you're you. God didn't make you to look like her over here. He didn't make you to look like Gracie. He wanted you to look like Jillian. So don't worry about Gracie. Worry about Jillian. When you look in the mirror, you know you're beautiful. You know you're confident. Why are you worried about what anybody else got to say? You smile, you keep on going, and you let that shit ride. Build your confidence up. Take pictures. Laugh. Go to work. Shop. Do things that make you happy. Get your hair done. That's another thing that builds confidence. And also, natural faces are really, really beautiful. But if you want to put on some makeup, let me tell you, honey, put on some makeup, please, because I'm telling you, that's taking everything to the top. You see me? nah, for real, y'all. Confidence is very important. Like, I feel like without confidence, you don't have anything. Like, you know, like, you just a sad person. Like, people tell me I'm too cocky, and it's like, okay. Like, people tell me I'm bougie, and it's like, that shit is so fucking live to me. Because it's like, so you think I'm bougie, so when you look at me, you think, oh, yeah, she the shit. All right, I see what you see, too. Okay. So, that's how I feel about that. And I feel like with confidence, you just got to tell yourself, I can do it. I know who I am. And that's just the same thing with, like, you know, just achieving stuff and, like, feeling like, so I don't care. Like, I don't care if you're not built like Kylie Jenner. We're not rich. We don't have money to get surgery. We don't have money to get, you know, Kylie Jenner is very beautiful, but we don't have money. Like, you got to accept this shit. Like, you got to look at, you see this purple right here? I'm accepting this. That's who I am. I can't do anything about that. So I just feel like, you know, like, it blows me when people be like, oh, I don't like this about me. And I'm like, oh my gosh, like, you're so beautiful. Like, are you okay? And you don't need, back to the guy situation, you don't need a man to tell you you're beautiful or to tell you that he loves you. Like, this all comes with loving yourself. If you cannot love yourself, then why would you want somebody else to love you? Like, that's draining. Like, that almost drained me, because I'm over here, I'm trying to get you to love me. The whole time I'm trying to get you to love me and I'm loving you, I'm not loving myself because I feel like you don't love me. That's not adding up. So I feel like you need to love yourself within. Like, you need to be like, I'm okay. Can you be okay without this person? If this person leave you, are you going to be able to wake up? Are you going to be able to still continue your journey with life? Are you still going to be able to do what you got to do? Yes, you're going to be able to do what you got to do, because you're going to let this shit go. And done with that. Now let's talk about success and achieving your goals. Everybody that know me know I'm very big on success. I got a tattoo that say ambitious. I think I showed you guys this tattoo in my first Girl Talk video. I'm very big on success, determination, ambitious, and like ambition, and just like, you know, going after what you want, because I come from nothing. So it's like, all the people that told me I couldn't do this and I couldn't do that, I'm here. Like, I've done everything that I said I was going to do. And I'm still going. Like, I'm a whole brand ambassador now. Like, I still got stuff I'm doing. I'm still in school. Like, I got a lot of stuff going for myself. And I can't mess it up. So, I feel like with success, you know, like, if you come from the bottom, or like you ain't got much, you don't know what to do, I feel like it starts with you. Like, people be like, oh, you can't do that, you ain't never gonna be able to do that, this, this, and that. Let that, take that and be like, all right, it's cool, I know what I'm gonna do. Because it's like, when people do tell me that stuff, like, I just be thinking in the back of my head, like, bro, I'm finna blow the fuck up, like, my life is finna be crazy. And I still think that to this day. But success, don't let nobody stop you from doing you. You want to go build another Walmart part two? Go build a Walmart. You want to be the president? Go be the president. Do whatever you want to do. Because I feel like people are always going to have something to say. So why not do whatever you want to do anyways? And I feel like invest in yourself. And I feel like work hard. Like, people are like against 9-to-5s. And I feel like that's our generation, because like nobody wants a 9-to-5. Nobody wants to work under nobody. Everybody want to be their own boss. But can everybody do what it takes to be their own boss? You got the balls to do. Like, you got to get out here and get it. Like, nobody's going to give this shit to you. And I think I had to like learn that quick, because like I was like, but I want this and I want that. And I'm over here like, damn, I got to get off my ass. Like, once I saw that nobody like could get stuff done faster than me, like, if I ask somebody for some money and they'd be like, yeah, I can give you some money, but it'll be on Friday. No, because I want the money right now. So guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to go get off my ass and I'm going to go get the money. I'm going to have it before Friday. And guess what? When you give me that money Friday, I'm going to have double that. I don't have to wait on nobody, because I got my own legs. I can get off my own ass and I can go to work. You might be tired when you get off of work, but guess what? When you get that check, you're not going to be tired, because you can do whatever you want to do. And I feel like that 9-to-5 is going to get you where you need to be. Like, it's going to let you get, it's going to take you where you need to be. Like, you trying to invest, where are you going to get the money from? Oh, you want to do it illegally? Shit, fuck it. Do it illegally. I don't knock nobody hustle, because I feel like everybody got a story. Everybody got to do what they got to do. So, in that time, I mean, do you. And I feel like, you know, it's life. Like, we all got a lot of stuff to do. You know, don't let nobody stop you. And be successful. Instead of, another thing I tell you young girls, like, this is what I've taught myself. And I didn't even teach myself this. It just came with me, kinda. Like, I noticed that most people, like, they look at these girls on Instagram and out sometimes, like, out in public, they look good, they got nice stuff, like, girls, like, they got nice cars, nice nails, hair, everything, and they be like, oh, this girl thinks she all that, she thinks she's stuff, she thinks she this, and it's really not thinking it. Like, you don't have to think at it, like, you look at it like, damn, what do you do? Like, who you know that know this, how to do this, how to do that? That's how you network with people. You don't network with people. You don't get anywhere by like saying, I don't like her because she acts like this and she thinks she all that. And that car not even hers. I heard she got that from some. That is so lame. Like, you're never, I'm just keeping it a book. You're not going to get nowhere doing that. Like, you need to be like asking. It's not even about like kissing ass or looking friendly. It's about trying to network, trying to do what you got to do to be next. Like, hey, like, what's up, what you do, like, oh, you know, so-and-so, oh, yeah, I know so-and-so, I can put you on so-and-so, because he be needing models to do this for that, and it's like, bet, and it's like, boom, you didn't even hate on shorty, you saluted her, oh, I like your car, like, you really on your shit, like, that's what it's about, like, giving credit when it's due, like, stop hating, it's not even like that, and when you do that, God gonna put you in a position to get to where you need to be, because you looking out, you ain't hating. So far we didn't cover boys, success, and controlling emotions. I also want to talk about friendships. I want to talk about friendships because, oh Lord, I'm tired. I done had so many friends, and I noticed that sometimes I always end up by myself in the end. And I don't know, probably because I got a lot of maturing to do. I don't know, or it might not even be that, but I honestly think that I don't have a lot of friends because, like, I feel like I'm always better off by myself because I don't listen to people. Like, I don't follow people. Like, I like to do me. Like, and then I like to hang with people that think like me. Like, I want to be able to tell you, oh, I want to do this photo shoot with so-and-so, and I think I want to get my hair like this. I want you to be like, oh my gosh, like, yes, I can help you put this together. Like, what can we do? Like, I like hanging around people that benefit me, and I can benefit them too. So, like, if we both thinking about money, we both thinking about success, we both thinking about making it, we friends. Like, but I also have friends I laugh with, I kiki haha with, you know, they support or whatever. But I'm my biggest supporter. I'm the person that determine my success. I'm the person that's gonna get it for me. So instead of me waiting on everybody to be like, I support you, I got you, this and this and that, have myself. I can have friends laugh with, but when it's time for me to have myself, I'm all I'm thinking about. I ain't thinking about nobody else because I'm too busy worried about me. So friends are cool, you know, but don't get caught up. Ladies, do not get caught up following your friends. That shit is dead, bro. Like, I'm telling you, you're gonna look stupid. Like, don't follow nobody. Don't let nobody tell you what to do. Don't dress like this because she dressed like that. Don't bully so-and-so because they bully so-and-so. That shit is lame. I'm telling you, these females is rats. Like, they don't give a fuck. Like, person will go behind your back. You'll never think they'll do that shit. They will do it. I'm telling you, don't leave. And then, watch when you start being friends with them. It's gonna be hell on motherfucking earth. Oh, it's gonna be you this, you that, you that, you that, you that. I can't hear that shit because I'm too busy doing me. I'm too busy focused on my next move because it's like my mama always told me friends turn into busters. And I got friends, like I got good friends. Like I got a couple of friends, okay? I got a couple of friends. And the friends that I do have are good to me. Like, we laugh, you know, they deal with me. Like, I'm crazy. I really be thinking, I'm an overthinker, I'm a Capricorn. So, I feel like if you got friends and you love them, hold them close. If you know they good friends, don't do them wrong. You know, let them know how you feeling. That's a big part of friendships, communication. One of my friends told me that, communication. Don't just back out of stuff and just be like, you know what, I'm done fucking with you. Try to communicate, and if it don't work, then be done. Yeah, that's that. And just because you have friends don't mean you have to tell them your every move, your business. Because I used to be like that. I used to tell my friends everything I did just because I feel like, oh, you my friend. Everybody can't be trusted. So just because they're your friend don't mean they can be. Now we're going to be talking about growing up into a young woman. Growing up, adulting, doing everything on your own, taking responsibility, you know. I can say that. When I was in like, this is for like all my young girls, like in high school, middle school, whatever. Whenever I was in high school, I used to always think about what I wanted to do and what I wanted to do. Like people used to be laughing at me and shit. And I was dead ass. Like people, I used to be thinking about success so much. Like I used to think about success so much that she used to make me cry. Like I knew I cried over boys, but like y'all, I'm telling y'all, I will cry about my success. Like if I don't make it, I will cry every day. So that means a lot to me. But in high school, I thought about success a lot. And this comes with adulting. Like, I was like, man, I can't wait till I do this. I can't wait till I do that. When I graduate, I'm gonna do this. Plus I had been working. I was working. I was 16. I was a cheerleader. I was doing all that. So I was working and you know, so I kind of had already had a little taste of like adulting a little bit. Like when I was a cheerleader, it was like I was living two lives. I was a high school kid, then I was also an adult. Because I would go work with the grown people and have to put on my grown act. And then I would go back to school with the cheerleaders and football players and have fun and just do whatever I wanted to. But it was hard because it was like, I'm an adult and I'm balancing both. And that actually taught me that, like, you know, like, I know, like, everybody, after we graduated, everybody jumping in, going to work, getting stressed out. I already went through that. I've been working since I was 16. So that's not nothing to me. I know how to make my own money. I know how to get off my ass and go to work. So after I graduated, it was a big slap in the face. It really wasn't a big slap in the face. For some people, it is, because it's like, oh, shit, like, or, like if you get pregnant or something, or, like, or if something happened, like your mama put you out or something, or like if you don't go to school, like that's gonna be a big, big slap in the face, because it's gonna be like, shit, like I just graduated, now I got a baby, now I don't got nowhere to stay, this and this and that. And it's probably a lot for some people to take in, but this is for people that want to go to school. Like, it's a big slap in the face, because, like, especially if you come from the bottom, you don't have nobody, it's like, damn, I gotta get off my ass. Like, you gotta get a job. And then it's like, stuff don't come on your time. Like, you gotta understand that everybody grown. Like, people make their money. Like, you gotta act like an adult. Like, you gotta do mixed business with business. Like, you want a car, you gotta work for it. Like, you gotta know how to manage your money. You gotta know how to, you know, not let your feelings get in between your money and your business, because it's like, you wanna do this for yourself so your kids can have this. Grow up, adult. Stop hanging around the same ass people every day that's not doing nothing. You gotta, you know, cut a lot of people off to get to where you need to be. And then you gotta work. It's okay to have fun. It's okay to go to parties. I go to parties. But I am also trying to chill out on this stuff, because it's like, damn, like, I'm at this party and it's like, the whole time I'm at the party, I'm thinking about, why the fuck I'm not living like Beyonce? This is why I'm not living like Beyonce. I'm at this damn party shaking my ass. I need to be somewhere, you know, with my mind and my head on straight. And it's cool. We all not going to be straight. We all make mistakes. We all think about stuff. We all do crazy stuff. But I'm saying, that's adulting. Adulting is taking the responsibility and knowing what you got to do before you got to do it. Oh, you want to get your nails done. You want to get your hair done. But your tuition due. Your people not helping you pay your tuition, you pay your tuition. Okay, I got the money for my tuition. I got to get my nails done because I want to go out. If you know you got hustle, you going to have the nail money and the tuition money. But if you know you content and you okay with, like, okay, I just got to give my tuition and I can't get my nails done this week, then that's you. But it's all about also having hustle. Like, if you know you got this tuition, do you got that tuition money put up? Shit, I'm going to double back and I'm finna get the money to get my nails and toes and hair done, because I wanna look cute. And I also wanna have everything paid for. So that's adulting. And you guys, I feel like, you know, all this stuff ties together, like boys, friendships. Cause it's all like boys, friendships, success, self-esteem. Like, you all gotta mix this, you gotta mix that stuff in together, because it's like, at the end of the day, everything is falling back on you. Love yourself, take care of yourself before you take care of anybody else, because at the end of the day, who you got, who is this right here, who crying, who know how you feel when you go to sleep, who crying at night, who wake up smiling? You, nobody else. They gonna look out for them, so look out for you. And it's like, at the end of the day, do what you gotta do to, you know, fulfill your dreams. You know, to be happy, to be peaceful, cut people off. You know, don't stay with toxic people. Toxic people are not good. Work on yourself as well, because people need to learn how to work on themselves. I need to learn how to work on myself. Nobody is perfect. And I hope I touched base on everything with you guys. I hope, you know, I talked about everything. I went through a lot of stuff. And I did talk about sex. I talk about not letting God peer pressure you. And, oh, I also want to talk about one last thing. I want to talk about, like, drugs, weed, you know, all that stuff, liquor. You know, we young. We going to hit the blunt a couple of times. We going to might get drunk a couple of times. But I feel like, don't let it become a habit. I'm not judging people that do smoke. Some people got to smoke to get through the day. But I'm saying, like, don't let that stuff affect you and what you got doing. Because people, they want to smoke, they want to drink, they want to do all this, but can't even afford that shit. How the fuck you going to want to smoke every day and you can't afford it? How the fuck you want to get high every day, but you looking for the next meal? How that's going to work? No, get your shit together. Then maybe you can hit a blunt or something. Like, you're not going to never hear me saying, okay, I'm finna buy the whole bottle. I'm not buying no damn bottle. If y'all want me to get drunk, y'all better buy the bottle and I'm going to take a little sip. That's it. Because I know I'm not an alcoholic like that. So I'm not going to be too excited to get it. Like, maybe a margarita. That's stuff that make me. But, yeah, and I feel like it's all about success. I feel like life is all about loving yourself, doing what you got to do to make it, cutting everybody off, and staying true to you and being happy. Be your peace. Don't let nobody change you, ladies. We need to stick together. We need to come as one, because at this point, everybody trying us like we weak this year, and we not going for that. Pussy is power. We are going to stand up together. We are going to take on this upcoming 2021 year. We're going to be good, you know, like, come on. Have a strong mind. I'm trying to have a strong mind so that I can have a strong mind for y'all. And, you know, don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your dreams. Don't give up on your dreams. Stay focused. Stay focused. Stay focused. Stay consistent. Keep working. Always have that in the back of your head. I can do it. I can do it. I can do it. The more people say you can't do it, you don't listen to them. If you listen to them, that's when you start thinking, damn, I can't do it. But the whole time, you can do it. It's all in your head. So all I gotta say is, you know, let's recover this. Safe sex. Have good people in your life. Loving people. Don't let nobody peer pressure you into having sex with them. You know, guys come and go. Don't sit up there and cry, because it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. You know, have good friends. Be successful. Manage your money. Save your money. Do everything you got to do, man, you know, to love yourself. Like, I hope you guys took a lot in from this video. Because I have been wanting to talk to y'all about a lot of stuff in a minute, because I want to inspire people. I want to inspire people to chase their dreams, to, like, you know, let people go that they love, even though it's hard. Like, don't let nobody run over you. Be strong. Be a warrior. Don't let nobody take advantage of you. You know, value yourself. Know your self-worth. Like, man, I'm a whole ass person. I got to be strong. No, I'm just playing. No, I hope y'all enjoyed this video, because I enjoy talking to y'all. I always enjoy talking to y'all. But until further notice, I'm about to go, and I hope to see y'all in my next video. I love y'all. Thank y'all so much. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'm so happy that y'all are following me on this journey. I'm getting my subs up. Like, let's go, y'all. Follow me on Instagram. We got good energy, positive energy. I love the girls. I love the ladies. You know, pussy is power. So we gonna keep this stuff going, and I'm gonna be back with another video. Mwah. See y'all later.